everyone. I just thought I'd give you a little update on what I've been doing today. I've been quite busy getting a YouTube page, channel, they call it, made up, and been quite busy with that the last few days. But today I've kind of run out of time a bit, really. I've got to get some pictures chosen and prepared for a couple of local exhibitions that are coming up. And usually I hate doing that because it's a case of measuring all the frames I've got, measuring the pictures, and I'm not a very prepared person, so it's a bit of chaotic. And I never quite know what's going to go with what, really. So I don't really look forward to doing that. But when I was starting it this morning, I thought, oh, this is a great opportunity to show you how I go about getting ready for an exhibition. And I took a little video this morning anyway and just showed you the pictures that I had to get out and choose, really, pictures that I haven't shown at these particular exhibitions before. And yeah, so I took a little couple of videos of those, and then I just thought, well, I'll just, instead of doing the text, I'll just put a video of me telling you about it, really, with it, so that you know what's going on. And if you can see the picture behind me there, that's Candy. That's a friend of mine, her dog, one of her dogs. And I've always really liked that picture because it's lovely and bright. It's an unusual combination, but I do like bright colours. And it sets Candy off really well, I think, that colour. And it's kind of candy coloured. I rather like that. So, but the thing is, it's a tiny bit small, the background. The pink is a bit lacking. So I'm going to try and patch it up a bit on the edges and see if it will fit into a mount, because the mount that I've got for it and the picture that will go well with it, the frame that will go well with it, is really, that picture is a bit skimpy. So I'm going to try and patch it up, and I'll have a go at videoing that and show you what I do, show you how I would patch up pictures like that, because I've had to do a few of those. Only because I'm not organized. If I was organized, really, with all my pictures and the frames, you know, before I even started them, that would be a different thing. Wouldn't have to do that. But it's a challenge. It's finding that color again. There, on the side of her nose, it is a bit orangey in with the pink as well, which I love orange and pink together. So I think I'll be able to do it. Anyway, I'll video it and see if we can show you how I do it. Okay, I'm gonna cut stop now and then have a go at that and see if I can video that. I might even try and video it here on Zoom, because it's only, you know, you won't need to see any detail or anything. I'll see how it goes. I'm just trying out things, really. Okay, see you later. Right, how do I turn this off? Okay, here it is. End. Yeah, so before I start, I've just noticed that there's a black charcoal line or pastel line at the very edges. So I'm going to try and get that off. It's very unlikely that it'll be pencil, because I don't use pencil with pastel, because try not to get my hands in the way then. I try not to use pencil with pastel because it doesn't mix very well. This is quite a strong line, so I think it will have been where I would have planned to put it into another frame or something to mount. See, the thing is, my husband does my mounts for me mainly. And he can just make them to any size that will work in a frame that I maybe have. I can often adjust the color if I need to, but usually I don't have to do all this kind of thing. But I've got a perfect frame for it, and the mount is already cut, so it'll look okay in that. It's a cream mount, so it'll bring out the cream in her fur, in her hair. So I think it'll go very well. So that's why I want to use it really. And if I can get this okay at the sides, it's worth having a go, isn't it, really? Because if you can't do it, if it doesn't work out, you've lost nothing. And it could work really well. But it makes sense to get rid of this black off as far as I can. But you can see the way I'm using the putty rubber. You don't use it like a normal rubber. It won't rub out, but it will take off a lot of the pastel. Very, you have to just be a bit patient with it really, and keep going over it till it's gone, and you'll notice that it comes off on the rubber. I can see it coming off. You probably can't see it, but as I say, it's not a detail that you really need to see. I just wanted you to really see whether we can do it. And it's a good opportunity for you to see how I use putty rubber. So I'm just stroking the paper, really. I'm not pressing, and it does take it off. It's very good. These are amazing, these putty rubbers. You could use them for drawing. You could use them when you use charcoal. If you're using charcoal on its own and you're doing a portrait, you draw with the rubber. You put the charcoal on, then you just take it off with this in places that you want it taken off. And as long as you can do it gently enough and get a nice transition, it's really, really good. You see that? Yeah, I probably will cut this a bit because it's a bit like watching paint dry. Yeah, if I was watching this in real time, I'd have skimmed through by now. I wouldn't be able to watch this. I'm not patient enough. Which is why I want to show you how to do pictures quickly. There's plenty of people out there like me that won't sit through an hour at a time. And if they sat through half an hour of any kind of demo, they'll want to feel at the end of it like I would, that we've covered some scope there. We've covered some lots of details, and then you can just go away and practice it. There's nothing worse than sitting there for half an hour and thinking, well, what have I learned there? I thought I was going to get something, but nothing happened. And I've had 14 years of that. So I want to show you that you're not going to have to do that. I'm going to be delighted to show you that. Nothing nicer. Save people time. Move people on in what they want to do. It's great. Okay, so there's a lot off there. Okay, so I'm going to just guess this now, and I'm going to try with the kind of, I think it might, no, it probably wasn't that one because I've got one here. It's quite worn down and I probably use this on other pictures. Yeah, this is the one that. So I'm just going to go over that black line. These lines here are okay, but I'm just going to go down a little bit more. But that's probably going to be fine. Oh, it's really nice doing this again actually because it's reminding me of when I painted it. Well, I drew it. See, I don't call this painting. A lot of people do actually, which is why I sometimes do call it painting. But I think it's drawing. It feels more like drawing to me because it's all dry. And a painting is painting. Although when you're using the colour shaper tools, they're all like paintbrushes. It does feel more like your, painting. And these sticks are, they really are much better for doing the background because just to mix the colours nicely. It's harder with pencils, it's much more labour intensive with pencils. This is a lot quicker. You're doing a big space and you just rub it. Yeah, it's that easy. Look, it's gonna work. Good guess. We're blending it in with that. So there's a bit of orange there. I still see a bit of line there, but not, your eye isn't going to be really drawn to that. And when we get enough pastel, when we get enough pencil on here, different colours, and we'll make it more mottly, you won't see that. This is the sort of thing that when you first start, you don't know that that will never go away. So you think, oh my God, I better rub it a bit harder. But actually, the more you rub it, the more the line appears because you're rubbing the pastel in. If you put more on top, it will disappear. And as you can see, I've left a bit of the background shining through, coming through actually. You maybe not can see it through there, but yeah, you can see sort of a mottly effect. There's a bit this side as well. I'm going to do this side as well. Just so we've got a bit of room to play with when we're mounting it. I'm hoping to show you when I do my mounting how I do it. It's quite nice to see someone doing a bit of mounting because I felt rather daunted when I had to do some mounting. I really hated it. And my husband really helped me a lot with that because he's been used to doing stuff like that when he was at art college. So he helped me a lot with that. Often bother his eyes. He's got a really good eye for what looks right and what doesn't. And as I said to you before, that's a good thing about being in a group because this is what we can do for each other. We can help each other out there and say, oh, yeah, that looks fantastic. Or, well, yeah, maybe just make that a little bit darker. But you're on the right track. Just stuff like that, really. And it really builds your confidence. It really does, because it's very hard to be objective about your own pictures. I think I'm probably a little bit unusual like that because although I may not be sure about stuff like this, is that going to go away? May not go away, but really it's so close to where we're going to mount it, or either mount it on the line that's still showing there, because lost my track then. Anyway, I'm going to put some orange in now, and we want a nice bright orange. Nice and bright. Now, a lot of the oranges up in this corner, so I'm going to go a bit mad with it up there. You can do it, you just do it, it looks right and you're happy with it. Yeah, what I was saying was I think I'm a little bit unusual for an artist. Well, I don't really call myself an artist, really. I've only just started saying I'm an artist since I've been doing this online stuff. I think it sounds a bit presumptuous, really. Anyway, I've always been absolutely amazed by my pictures, to be honest. I've been amazed that I can do it. I didn't think I was going to be able to draw. I don't actually try. I've always been really very happy with what I've produced. And yeah, they could probably be a lot better, but I'm happy with them. Whereas a lot of artists, they have trouble with accepting their capabilities and thinking, well, yeah, you know, what I've done there is expressed how I felt about it, and I'm happy with that. A lot of people have trouble with that. You know, they want it to look perfect. In the beginning, I wanted things to look perfect, and I just thought, well, yeah, but it's okay, but it's very tedious, isn't it? It is tedious. For me, it is anyway, because I've always been used to doing things since I was a kid that take a lot of time, things like sewing and sewing particularly. I didn't draw much when I was a kid. I did draw a bit, but not a great deal. I was more into sewing, really. And it's very, very slow. But I always had no problem with that. I always found it was nice. It was very, for me, it's very therapeutic to take your time. But I was good at embroidery. But when I started to draw, I knew that it can take a lifetime really to be anything really great. And if you're, you know, if you're having fun with it and make a good thing that you're happy to look at, there's nothing nicer, really. But it does take a bit of accepting what you will be achieving. I'm just making this a bit more dense here because it's looking a bit dark and I've got a lot of extra pastel in there. This one's better. Love that pink. Anyway, I'm going to blend it in now, so this is what we do. Just keep doing it till you're happy with it. Just carry on. That's the great thing about this paper. Now, if this was other kind of paper, most other kind of papers that are designed for pastel, oh, they're hard work. They really are hard work. You know, you put the pastel on, start blending it in, and before you know it, you're rubbing it all off. Especially if you use these blending tools, or blending stumps. Especially if you use those, it takes the pastel off. And on this kind of paper, these don't really spread the pastel around as good as finger. But you'll find that out for yourself when you start using it. This is it. I mean, really, the learning really is in doing it. But if you've watched videos and they're using these, and they haven't been clear about the paper they're using them on, you think, well, why isn't it working? Why can't I do this? And you think, oh my God, you know, this is laborious and it's no fun because you want to get somewhere and you can't get there. And you see them all on YouTube and they do it, oh, no problem. But they haven't been vigilant about telling you that this is on this kind of paper. These don't work very well on pastel mat. They really don't. I don't think so. They just take the pastel off. Okay, so but you need to know that at the start. Anyway, this is looking pretty. Very pretty. I'm going to put a bit more pink here. Make it a bit more. I'm not putting orange in there. Oh. But I wanted it to go lighter, warmer there. To make it look like the sun is coming into her face. To you know, the way I feel about it is that if you're going to put a background in, it should really help your picture, not distract from it. A lot of busy backgrounds are lovely, and a lot of people really want that when they're having their pet done, which is fair enough. You know, if you're doing a picture for somebody and they want something particularly, then you have to do that. But if you're doing a picture for yourself, then you can have some fun with it. But for me, this is a help to show you where the light's coming from. And when I take my photographs of this, I make sure it's a sunny sunny day as the light is coming in from this way. And you know, you're often told don't take your photos on a sunny day, but you can use the sun because it makes it look more real. That's what I found anyway. You don't have to do it like that. It's just, that's what I like to do. You'll find your own ways that you like to do things. So put some a lot more energy. Oh, didn't it? Yeah, they get softer on the side that you've been using and they're a bit hard. Now, if they're too hard, they can actually scratch this, or any paper actually. This is feeling a bit hard. So, yeah, I'm gonna scrape this off on a bit of paper here. Just paper towel. Just scraping this off on a bit of paper towel. Because I don't like the feel of that. Not orange, red really. It's red really. Yeah, be careful with this because if they're hard, they will scratch the paper and you'll see a line in it. A lot of people like to put their backgrounds on first. In fact, I probably did put this on first. I can't remember. I'm trying to keep these colours separate so they don't blend into one other colour, you know, to the pink and orange are going to make another colour. So I'm trying to keep them separate so you actually do, you are seeing different colours. Yeah, I think that's okay. I want it to be more pink and the orange coming in like that. So, yeah. Yeah, you can still see the line, but when you get a mount on that, it'll be very close to the shadow of the mount as well. You'll always get a little bit of shadow, which, you know, I think we'll get right there. I think that's enough. That's fine. I'm just going to wipe my hands and then I'll turn the video off. So, hope you've learned a few tips there, and you know that we've made use of what I'm doing today. It's been ages since I've done any drawing. Actually, I'm going to do a bit of drawing now. I've got a white Maine Coon cat that I want to finish for my exhibitions. So, but I'll have to set up my camera and that for so you can see the rest of that. Because I am hoping one day that I'll be able to make a proper video of that, the whole project put together. Anyway, see you later. I'm still getting used to where I'm supposed to be looking here. It's there, I think. I think there you are. See you later. Say bye to Candy. Candy says bye. I'm just adding a little bit on the end now because I forgot to show you what I do when I've got a lot of pastel on or before I put any of my pictures into the frame and under glass. You have to, rather than spray any of your work, which takes the colour, it dulls it right down. It's horrible. To stop it smudging, you press the colour into the paper. You're pressing the pastel right into the paper as much as it will go. And I put the tape up there to stop this tape moving around. You have to be careful when you're doing this. You don't want it to, you don't want the paint going on this little nose, on our little nose. So you have to be, because I haven't touched candy, just from the background. This is the glassine paper that the candy was wrapped in. Whenever I finish the picture, I always do this when I finish a picture anyway. And then I put the glassine on, and then you can just pop it away. And it won't smudge. But when you've got glassine on your picture, you don't even want this sliding around on it. So you have to be really quite vigilant about this. Keep it nice and steady. Make sure, just use a bit of paper towel. It's better than fingers at this point. And just, you're pressing that pastel right into the paper. It doesn't really look much different. It does take a bit of pastel off onto the paper, but I'll show you how much now, because I think that's enough. So you just then take it off. And you see the pink on there. I'll take it off so you can see it properly. No, you can't really see it, but yeah, at that angle you can slightly see it. It's the kind of pink, there's a pink line going across where her nose was. There at the back, there's all pink in the background. It's very slight, it's very difficult to see really. But yeah, I think you can see it just about there. So that's how much pastel comes off. And then I just clean that off with a paper towel. And then I'd use a fresh piece to put over candy again till we frame it. But I'll probably do a bit of framing tomorrow, I think. I'm psyched myself up for it. It's not one of my favourite jobs. Got to be very careful about opening glass and getting bits off and the rest of it. Anyway, that's it. Okay, we're really finished now. Okay. Candy. There we go. Bye.